So today we're off again on another little adventure. We're going up to Hamble today to go and have a go around their little kind of docked area. Similar tactics again, we're going to try a bit of free lining, little jig heads, a bit of free lining bacon, maybe put a bit of bread on for the mullet.
Yeah, see if we can get one of them.
Well, thank you for all of the interest on the last video. We're pretty chuffed with the views it's got and the comments and all of the likes as well, so thanks for that. We did get one strange comment from Gary.
Gary Smart,
yeah.
An ironic name.
Yeah.
I'll pop the comment up here, you can see if you can decipher that.
But yeah, I'd like to know your views on that as well. That would be quite interesting as well. Just to make clear as well, we don't take every fish we catch. We don't take undersized schoolies and chuck them on a barbecue. It's not how we work. It's all for fun. Well, thank you anyway, and let's get into some action.
Right, we had a good rinse around the old key or whatever it was. Not a lot there, a few mullet. We did buy a bit of bread, but they just weren't interested, so. We've come down to Hamble Point now, in between Hamble Point and Hamble. In between Hamble Point and Westfield Common sort of area. So we'll flip you around in a minute, show you lovely scenic Fawley Towers over there. And we're going to whip a few lures around. I'm going to put my carp rod out with a bit of bacon on it as well. See if that does a nice bass. So.
Sally of the day. Here we go. Nice one, mate. Not bad, schoolie.
That's an alright fish.
Little 1 pounder, 1.5 pounder.
Yeah, on the Fox Rage lure. He's not opening his job for me, though. There we go, guys.
Very nice, mate, well done.
First fish of the day.
Get a couple more, eh?
Yep.
Right, so as it turns out, guys, this fish that I'm about to hook into here actually turned out to be an endangered species. We've decided to keep it in the video just for educational purposes because, as you can see at the time, I had absolutely no idea what it was. Most experienced sea anglers would probably know, and I'm not going to reveal what it is just yet. Make a guess and I'll tell you after we show you the clip. But yeah, these fish must be returned to the water immediately, preferably no photos, no evidence of its existence, just unhooked, put straight back. We did put the fish straight back. It did take a little while to swim off, but fortunately it did, so hopefully he'll be okay. But yeah, just a little word of warning. I wouldn't usually include a clip like this, but just so people can see what it looks like and that it needs to go back if caught. So there you go. Hope you enjoy this little clip here anyway. Let's get back to the action.
Got another one on, boys. Better fish, innit? Looks like a bit of a better bass over here.
What the hell is that?
What's that? Right, guys, not sure what that is.
What is that? Come on, guys.
What the hell is he?
I'm gonna put it back.
Yeah.
I don't know what it is, but.
That's another fish, though, mate. What the hell it is, we don't know. Yeah, he's fine, hold him up, right, he'll go.
He's going back.
Alright, guys.
this worm back off, so hopefully it'll be all right. I don't have a clue what it was still. I'll do a bit of research and I'll insert into this video, but I really thought that was a bass until I saw this big purpley flank come up, and God knows what that was. It looked like some sort of tropical sea species. I've got to get off this point now anyway.
Yeah, we're going
to cut off.
Okay guys, so we've had this fish identified for us by a couple of people, and the most popular opinion seems to be an Alice shad.
Right guys, we're just going to have a wander up, just up to this pier over here, if you can see it in the distance. That one little schooly jaw dad, and then the mystery fish. Let's see if there's any more mystery fish around it. We still have no idea. We had a look online, but can't really find any information on it.
Well, I only had a quick search, but we're not highly experienced sea anglers by any means, but we know of most of the sea species, and we've caught most of them as well, so God knows what that was.
Might be something to do with this big power plant here.
It might be, some mutant.
So guys, just getting up to this pier now. Jules just over there, he's going to put his little carp rod with bit of bacon on the end of it and just whip it out there as well. It's just still the two fish at the moment, but we're hopeful for another couple. We've got a couple of hours to be able to work on this place. Look, I don't know if you can see that, but... yeah, there we go, we're on boys, we're on. One-eyed walleye.
There we go, look. That's a nice little fish. Fish number three of the day. Two bass, one mystery.
One mystery fish.
Just chill out, mate. Pop it out, mate. I'm just going to have to help Geordie. He can't really unhook fish. Right, fish number three of the day.
Only a little
diddler. Yeah, only little ones so far. Hopefully we're striking something a bit bigger later on, but fish is a fish nonetheless.
We've got a couple of hours, haven't we? So
yeah.
Let's give it a go, mate.
Nice scenic view over here.
Treat myself to a little cinnamon swell, I think.
Right, so we had a good walk up that way, had a few fish there. The tide sort of come in now, it's up at high, and the fishing sort of died off a bit over there. So we're gonna head back down the other direction, just come back to the van, quick resupply, change your battery, and yeah, let's go and catch a couple of barramundis, whatever they were. Absolutely scorching as well today for late October. Halloween in a couple of days, and we're out here with t-shirts on down by the beach, so happy days. Global warming.
Alright guys, so we're just walking back to the van now. We're probably going to call it a day. I have a couple more casts. George's been in a bird's nest most of his day. But yeah, I have a few more casts around up here. And that will be that.
Hello guys, thanks for watching that video. It was a bit of a rubbish one today, minus the mystery fish, which we still haven't found out what it is yet. So
I'm sure you guys probably know before us because we'll do a bit of research later, but no big bass today, unfortunately. A couple of schoolies.
It was hard going, wasn't it? After we missed the rise of high tide, I don't think there was many there to be had, so we tried.
Maple and pecan, Bakewell tart, and we're out of here. Like and sub. Thanks for watching.